Merry Christmas from the Nicholsons!
Happy Christmas from the Andersons!
Merry Christmas, everybody, and a Happy New Year!
Happy Christmas!
Love from the Maynells!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas, everybody, and a Happy New Year!
Hello, just a Merry Christmas from me to everyone at Bethany City Church. I love doing life with you guys. I love being part of this church family. Thanks for having me, and I'm thankful we've got you. God bless.
Hello, everyone. Well, here I am in my early Christmas setting, but by the time Christmas comes, I will not be with you. I will be down in Christchurch staying with my son Mike and Karen, his wife Karen. I want to wish you all a joyful and meaningful Christmas and thank you for all your love and caring over this momentous year. Have a good time. God bless you.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Happy Christmas, everyone.
Love from the Woffs.
Including George.
I can't reach the button. I can't reach George. Get away.
Merry Christmas!
Hi, everyone. We hope and pray that you all have a wonderful Christmas and a fantastic New Year. Love from the Lindsays. Merry Christmas!
Good boy.
We'd like to wish you all a very Merry Christmas.
And a happy and healthy New Year. Merry Christmas.
Happy Christmas, everybody. Stay safe and well, thinking about you all. Happy Christmas. It's so nice to be able to come and join Mum and Dad here from South Africa. Hope you have a wonderful time.
All the best to everybody at Bethany for Christmas. Happy Christmas.
God bless.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas, and a Happy New Year.
We hope you have an amazing time. See you later.
Bye.
Bye.
Happy Christmas and all the best. Lots of love.
From the Millers.
Good morning. We just want to say a very Merry Christmas to everyone. We hope you have a wonderful time and a great new year. God bless.
Hi everyone. Wishing you a Merry Christmas from Margaret.
And Margaret.
Hi, my name is Mohammed. Merry Christmas and have a wonderful year.
Hi, this is Bahadur. I wish you the best Christmas ever.
Hi, my name is Anna. I wish you a very, very happy Christmas.
Hello, my dear friends. I wish you a very, very happy Christmas. I wish you the best to encounter the best happenings in the new year. I wish you a very, very happy life. My name is Mustafa. I am a new Christian, but my faith is so strong because of the teachings of my good teachers and those who helped me to grow my faith.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Happy Christmas, everyone.
Just want to wish you all a very happy Christmas, even if it's a bit quieter than usual.
Good morning. Happy Christmas to everyone and best wishes for 2021 from the Pattersons.
Merry Christmas, everyone. And every blessing for 2021.
Hi guys, it's Alex and Archie. We just want to wish you a Merry Christmas and everything's going to be okay and we'll see you soon. Bye!
Hello everybody. Merry Christmas from Lewis Miller.
A Merry Christmas from Enrique. We hope you have a great year and 2021 is ending. Wait, what year is it next year? It's 2020. 2020 is ending, so hopefully 2021 will be a better year. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year from Enrique and Lewis.
Happy Christmas from the Corleys.
Merry Christmas to you all from the Erringtons.
and welcome to the Great Bethlehem Bake Off.
This week's theme is the Nativity, so each of our bakes this week is focusing on one of the characters from the Nativity story.
We're starting things off with angel cakes.
And of course, that helps us focus on the angel Gabriel.
Whoa, what's this? Let's scroll up, open it.
Alicia, Amelie and Lucy are creating angel cakes.
Making angel cakes.
Right, have we got everything we need?
No butter. Angel Gabriel told Mary that she was going to have a baby. And baby Jesus is God's son.
Make sure to preheat the oven really hot.
So when the angel came, what do you think Joseph must have felt like?
Terrified.
These cakes, complete with angel wings, represent the angel Gabriel. After appearing to Mary to announce her pregnancy, the angel appeared to Joseph. Gabriel said, "You will name the baby Jesus. He will save his people from their sins."
Those fingers.
The angel cakes should be light and fluffy with a yummy creamy filling. They will be finished with delicious angel wings.
Whoa, does it feel like an angel wing? I knew that was gonna happen.
Next, we need to add some salt.
Salt?
Really? Let's see what actually salt.
The salt in this recipe helps us remember when the Bible tells us to be salt and light in the world, making it a much better place to live.
Am I bright?
Yes. I've never seen an angel before. Have you?
No.
Well, you don't see that every day.
Well, yes, you don't.
I think the angel was excited to tell Mary the news.
Yeah, of course. Why?
Because she's having a baby. And who's a baby? Jesus.
The cakes need to be in the oven until golden brown. Once they have risen, leave to cool.
I'm going to cut a hole out like that for the angel wings.
What would you do if the angel appeared to you?
I'll be scared.
Me too.
Lucy is adding a moist and delicious buttercream filling. Alicia and Amelie are finishing off their angel cakes with an icing sugar dusting of snow.
Hey, how do you move?
Now I am putting glitter on this cake.
Time for the taste test.
This is so yummy! So yummy!
It tastes good.
Why was the salt in it?
I don't know.
Thanks to the Burens for those beautiful bakes.
Nice bit of alliteration there.
I do try my best. Anyway, this next character is Mary.
Mary, the mother of Jesus, who travelled to Bethlehem on a donkey.
This next bake represents her, but it's not really a bake, it's a drink.
Sophie, Ben, Harry and Lily have been tasked with creating a bake-off first, a drink.
Why was your cocktail called the Virgin Mary cocktail?
Because the Virgin Mary gave birth to Jesus.
She could have drank this during her pregnancy because it's full of vitamins, which were good for her.
And the Tabasco sauce.
The what?
Tabasco sauce, right here.
With ingredients prepped, they wash their hands, ensuring that they adhere to COVID hand-washing guidelines.
Happy birthday to you.
I think we should start with the fruit.
The Virgin Mary cocktail introduces our next nativity character, Mary, the mother of Jesus. Gabriel visited Mary and told her that she would call the baby Emmanuel, which means God is with us.
Not yet.
That tastes sour.
Because she was pledged to be married to Joseph, they had to travel to Bethlehem on a donkey.
Poor Mary, having to ride on a donkey while she's pregnant.
I know, I've seen pregnant women struggling to walk. Never mind riding a donkey all that way.
This looks disgusting.
Smells quite nice though.
Aren't they meant to be going in your jug?
We've already got a little. We can eat the rest.
Oh, I see.
Harry and Lily's version with a Tabasco sauce kick is recommended to be served on the rocks. Harry clearly likes his with more of a kick.
Now let's give it a big stir. I hate bits. I'm gonna go and get the sniff.
Oops.
Oops indeed.
I really enjoyed it, I think. Like, it was quite fun.
There was a few spillages while we were making it, but it was really fun.
Super spillage.
That is really nice. And right now Ben's just gonna add some Sprite to it.
To give it a bit more fizz.
Nice.
That was tasty.
You can try my one, I try yours.
Okay.
Sophie's cocktail has delicious fruity bits. Ben's not so sure.
I didn't really like that one. I really liked it. I wasn't so keen on the bits, but I really liked it when it had a bit of fizz in it.
I was the same. I wasn't so keen on the one with bits, but my favourite was the one with the fizzy in.
That was yummy.
That was really nice. I can't wait to have it again.
I enjoyed making that Virgin Mary cocktail, did you?
Yeah, but next time I think we should make it without tomato juice.
Yeah, maybe more fruity.
Oh, I'm hot! Oh!
Not as hot as hers.
But somehow, mine was really spicy.
Because I put extra Tabasco sauce in yours.
Harry! You nearly burnt my tongue.
I can't believe Harry did that to Lily.
Shocking! Anyway, this next bit's something that you don't see every week on the Great Bethlehem Bake Off, but we've got a special Christmassy treat just for you.
Enjoy!
Frozen light. Forevermore. He shall reign forevermore.
Forevermore.
Oh, come, let us adore.
Welcome back.
Hello, we're good, Carol, me.
Our next character in the Nativity is the shepherds.
The shepherds travel to Bethlehem to worship the baby Jesus.
Now you might be wondering, what cake could we use to represent the shepherds? Well, actually, it's shepherd's pie.
It's time to cook up a heartwarming number with our next hugely popular bake, shepherd's pie.
Peas, mince, onions, herbs, carrots, potatoes, oxos, and shepherds.
Where are the shepherds?
This wholesome family meal represents the shepherds in our nativity story. After the angels delivered the good news to them, they said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's go and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about."
Here's the potatoes, girls.
Dan's got a new way of making his mashed potato.
I'm going to put the mince in the pan.
I'm going to chop the carrots.
I'm going to peel the potato.
What's wrong, Ben?
The onions.
It's all getting a bit emotional with these onions on the go, but Alex has found a genius tear-proof way of doing things. Until he sticks his face into the blender.
Ow! How do you think the shepherds would have felt when an angel just randomly appeared in their field while they were just chilling out?
I don't know, Dagger, what you would have done?
I would have been scared, I probably would have run away.
And why do you think it's related to the Nativity?
Because the shepherds that come to Jesus to see Jesus. It's like that if there's three shepherd pies, it's like that there's three shepherds.
I love potato.
I love potato.
I love potato.
And Katie, are you looking forward to trying the shepherd's pie?
Yes.
No.
Shepherd's pie can also remind us of when Jesus said, "I am the good shepherd."
What did one snowman say to the other snowman?
I don't know. What did one snowman say to the other snowman?
Can you smell any carrots?
Like shepherds, he watches over his flock, protects us from enemies, and is willing to go and find his lost sheep if they wander away. Time for the taste test.
That's delicious.
What do you think?
Hot?
Hot.
It's hot?
Mmm. Beautiful, Benny. Hey, I'm starting to get hungry after seeing all these shepherd's pies.
I don't think you need any more pies with that pudding.
Diet starts in January, man. These next characters are most famous for their gold, frankincense and myrrh.
It's time to bake some gingerbread wise men.
This is dessert, isn't it?
We're mixing the sugar slowly.
The Richardsons are tackling gingerbread wise men. The key to a perfect gingerbread man is ensuring a good snap. We don't want them to crumble. First off, mixing the ingredients in a big bowl.
I'm mixing the butter with the flour to make the gingerbread man.
After being whisked, baked, and adorned with sweets, these magi arrived from the east, asking, "Where is the newborn king? We saw his star and we have come to worship him."
This is a yucky job, Daddy. You wouldn't like to do this, Daddy.
I'm doing a good job.
The Richardsons have a secret super sweet and sticky ingredient of golden syrup.
And now we need to add the golden syrup.
They have also adopted a cost-effective way of getting their produce, which they're going to show us.
Two eggs, Daddy.
What a cracking idea.
Steph, are
anymore.
The story goes that the wise men brought gifts of gold, frankincense and myrrh. Okay. Not eggshells.
Shell. No! No, don't mix it.
Shell.
No!
Meanwhile, at the Browns' household, they have chosen to take a sneaky and clever shortcut and are transforming their standard gingerbread men into magically magnificent ones. Like the wise men, it's important for us to give our lives as a gift to Jesus. While Madeline focuses on decorating with precision, someone else only has eating on his mind.
I'm just performing some major surgery on this wise man.
I'm going to feed him baby Jesus. Once I've got my eyes on.
Do you think the three wise gingerbread men travels all that way?
Don't be silly, they're only biscuits.
Gold, frankincense,
more.
Look at me, I'm following the star.
Imagine having chickens in your garden. That would be excellent.
Anyway, as you probably guessed, our final character in the Nativity is baby Jesus.
And as the main character in the Nativity story, are we expecting something spectacular?
Something huge!
Something grand!
Something colourful!
Let's go to Anna to find out.
The Bible teaches that Jesus Christ, the Son of God, is the creator of the cosmos. In the beginning, everything was created through him. And as God, Jesus is all-powerful and all-knowing, yet he deeply desires to know
each and every one of us.
Sadly though, humanity doesn't want to know God. The only way God could communicate his love and awesomeness and demonstrate his grace and compassion was to speak to us on our level, literally, in person. So Jesus came to earth. Jesus had every right to come as a bold and powerful king. Born in a palace, but to resonate with real people, with real heartaches and real struggles, he chose a better plan.
In his birth, Jesus not only embraced poverty, but also humility.
Imagine, from all eternity, his home had been heaven,
surrounded by all the glory. But he willingly left all that behind and came down to share our lives on this earth. God took those humble beginnings to do something that would change the world.
Fast forward the years to when Jesus was an adult. People loved him, and one day he was surrounded by a crowd. Jesus taught them, "I am the bread of life. Those who come to me will never go hungry." He didn't say he was the wedding cake of life, but the bread of life.
If we want to live, we need bread. If we want to live forever, we need Jesus, the bread of life. Ask yourself this question: what place does Jesus Christ have in your life?
Christmas and all the fun that comes with it.
Even though this Christmas is a bit different because of COVID-19, we pray that we will have fun.
We pray that we would have a special time with people had our special, whether in person or on Zoom.
Thank you for our nativity today and for a reminder that you are the bread of life. You are all we need this Christmas and every other day.
We pray that this Christmas you'll help us to focus our eyes on you, even when we're eating yummy food and opening exciting presents. Help us to remember that you belong in the centre of our Christmas celebrations because you are our King.
In your precious name, Amen.
Wow. What an unexpected showstopper that was!
It was just like when Jesus stole the show that very first Christmas.
We hope you've enjoyed today's episode of the Great Bethlehem Bake Off.
And even after such a long and difficult 2020 for everybody, we want to still wish you a very
happy Christmas!
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let us heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the world, the Saviour reigns. Joy, unspeakable joy, an overflowing well, no tongue can tell. Joy, unspeakable joy, rises in my soul, never lets me go. Christ, your child is born, the King of kings and Lord of lords. And he shall reign forevermore, forevermore. Sacrifice Christ the Messiah. He within a manger lies, the one who made the starry skies. His baby born for sacrifice, Christ the Messiah. To our hopes and to our fears, the Savior of the world appears, the promise of eternal life.
Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us for this year's online nativity. We hope you've enjoyed it and that next year we're all back together in Bede Tower. All of Bethany Kids and volunteers wish you a very happy Christmas and a blessed new year. Bye!